Hello everybody, this is a Nerdy Geeky and I have literally just started this video from where we left off on the last one. We are going to see a... what is that? We're going to go see a crashed ship and we are going to see a ruin. I want to know, there must be ships in the atmosphere or something, I don't know. Anyway, we don't have time for that. We don't have time for that! Jeez, guys. So, I think the ruin's a lot closer because... it said on foot, like, the crash ship's like 3 hours away. So, let's cut to when we get to the ruin. Land Sebastian. I've renamed my ship Sebastian. Unofficially, of course. Right, here we go then. I do like finding ruins, but they all kind of look the same. The sameness of this is starting to get to me a little bit. I've said this in nearly all of my videos, and I'm just going to say it again, just in case this is like the first one that you've watched or you stumbled across and you're super bored, so if for some reason you're watching it. This game is not worth the £40 asking price. It's probably worth more like £20-25. Like, I would be happy to buy this game for about £20-25. But it's not worth £40 really. Because it's just a lot of the samey stuff because it's all procedurally generated, but they have not really added in like enough variation to the procedural generation, so therefore everything just ends up kind of looking very similar. I'm just going to learn a few Viking words from here, but I like the look. Like, they've got a very specific design to these ruins, and the game's going real slow right now and I don't know why. So seek help with the language, thank you. So yeah, like I said, I would have liked to have seen more extensive ruins, or maybe ruins that you have to like work out puzzles to get words or something, rather than just being given them. Or maybe a ruin where there's like traps inside, and you've got to like be careful. You know, kind of like the alien ruins in Skyrim. That was some of my sort of favourite parts of the Elder Scrolls game, was going to the alien ruins. I feel like just finding the stuff, it's almost not enough in that sense. I'm just going to get some chrysonite because this is the only planet in this system that has chrysonite. So if I find it, I'm just going to get some. But yeah, this is it's still fun. It's still fun. But like I said, if you're very flush and you can afford the £40, you really want to play this game, then go ahead and just do it. But know exactly what this is before you go into it. This is not exciting game, and it's not an action-packed game. It's just exploration, and that may seem boring, but I mean, I'm like I said, I quite enjoy that. So wow, 1 hour. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna hold A and D down. Planetary interference, that's fantastic. So we're gonna go into the atmosphere. Okay, actually know the names of the levels, the sort of layers of atmosphere, but I don't know them in the right order, so I'm not going to pretend like I do. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to slow down a bit. Thank you. No, oh, you know what, it can do this. It can be real tricky. And I'm just going to pulse engine. Look at that. That's the way to do it. And I'm still really far away. Right, so I'm nearly here. This was actually real, really, really annoying to find. Because it's literally on the other side of the planet. Like, that's how little is on this planet. There's a lot of, like I said, flora and fauna to find. There's not a lot of anything else. So let's have a look at this and see what we got. Doesn't seem to be many buildings or outposts on this one. Maybe it's too cold. Maybe the Viking do not like the cold. So let's click this thing first. This is a distress beacon, apparently. This was a pirate ship. Trophies fashioned from the bones of alien species adorn every available surface. Two pilots lie slumped behind the exit hatch, each plunging a dagger into the other's throat. Well, that probably didn't end very well, did it? There was a prize on board, and it was worth dying and killing for. My unease grows as I hear scratching emanating from the cargo hold, where, surely, the loot will be found. Let's send out a warning signal instead, because I feel like if I go into that cargo hold, I'm going to be mauled by a weird alien bear. Oh, sends a reward. Cool. All new technology. Coolant. Extreme heat. That's real useful on this planet. No, I've got the extreme cold one anyway. Yeah, I'm purposely not clicking on that. First, I'm going to everything else. Let's have a look at damaged machinery. Okay. I'm starting to find a lot of things that I already know. Oxide. Whatever the hell this would be. Yeah, that looks like oxide, doesn't it? Shield plate. You make it out of oxide before someone says it in the comments. Oh, that's quite cool. They sell for a decent amount, those Corvax cubes. So, what have we got here? We got a 25 slot. I see all these weapons. I'm just not bothered. This is more of a fighter. I'm more of a... I really want a lot of slots so I can just carry a lot of crap. Like, yeah, leave. I'm not going to leave it. See, what I really think they should have done really is, like, if you can put the resources into fixing a ship, after you fixed it, it can be like, do you want to sell it or do you want to keep it? And I think you should have the option of, like, selling it at some sort of low-cost price, but it was kind of worth you farming the materials for it. You know, that I think that would have been quite good, but... There's a lot to this game that they could... Ooh, that they could do. But it's going to be a while until it comes out. I'm gonna have a look at some mods soon as well. So if you want to keep an eye on this series, I might try out some of the mods. I know there's one that takes the haze off the planets, and it just makes the planets look really beautiful. Apparently, right? Ooh, it's a building. It's a building, guys and gals. Sorry, when I say guys, by the way, I'm not just referring to men or boys. Just in case people thought that. Wow, what a crap place to land that was. I guess I'm creeping up on them. I'm not getting back in. I'm not taking off. Yeah, when I say guys, I just mean everyone. It's just something they say. Something we say around here. Because I don't want people, like, taking issue with the fact that maybe I think only boys or guys play, you know, only you know, males play video games, because it's obviously not like that. Only men play video games. Well, am I right? No, I'm not. I'm joking. It's just a joke. It's just a joke. Okay, so we found that place. I've not actually gone into my thing and just and submitted all these places. I'll make some stuff for that. Like, let's go into here first. It's one of those little pods, so I don't think there's going to be anybody in here. What I'd love to do is find some sort of selling point on this planet and see what kind of things they've got for sale. Already know. Right, let's... This is one of the beacon things that I really did want to find for this episode. There it is. So, in my inventory. Not the multi-tool. I'm clicking all the wrong buttons today. So if we go E, build one of those. E, build one of those. I'm going to build four. We're going to click all four. I may just speed this up, though, because it's real boring to watch. Okay, then we've got, as you can see, we've got a drop pod and shelter, which is an observatory. We also have, I'm going to save it, we also have a plaque, like an alien plaque, and we also have an operations center. So we are going, oh yeah, of course it does it really fast. So we're going to go, look for them. I'm going to go find my ship. Right, it's behind this big old hill. So I'm making this video a little bit more choppy. I want to do a bit more in this. I know we looked at like a lot of the life on the planet. Oh, me thrusters. Whoa, sorry. Cool, right. So we're gonna go this way because there's two things. in the same direction. So it's the drop pod first, which will be another slot, so I'm about to spend another 260,000. I do tend to, like, every so often I'll have, like, 20 minutes or an hour or something farming. I can see some chrysanite crystals as well. I really don't have enough chrysanite at all, so I will be collecting chrysanite crystals if I see them. So I'm sure they're common on some places, but this is the only place. This is the only planet in this system out of the five planets that has any chrysanite on it. Cool, there we go, it's saved. Got this. The video sequences, like the little, they're nice, but they do kind of get on my tits after a while. Like, I just want to save it. Right, where's the opening? Here we are. This looks a little bit different. It's got rockets on this one. So there we go, my 39th slot. Yep, install the new slot. Cool, there we go. Gee, thanks. Spent like half a million on two slots. So yeah, this new multi-tool can just stay on like pretty much forever. Like, you see how slow that bar is going up, and when it goes to overheat, I've got such overheat protection on it now that it barely even overheats. So let's get back to the ship. Right, let's go. Oh, there's something down there, though, as well. I don't want to get too sidetracked, so I do want to go to the four places that we saw. But is this anything worth looking at? Oh, you know what? Let's drop down. Let's have a look. We haven't really got... We're about halfway through this episode. I've done quite a few cuts. So I can't always tell when I do cuts, because the time I'm looking at right now is just over 16 minutes, and it won't be that time that you're looking at, because I've cut a few things out. Discovered you, have I? Hey, we got a trade network. This is actually, I did want to have a look what kind of stuff I can get on the trade network here. Interesting fact, if you don't know, the Galactic Trade Network is also the name of the auction house system, effectively, on the Star Wars The Old Republic MMO game. They've used the same name, which, in all fairness, that's exactly what it is. It's a Galactic Trade Network. So it makes sense that's what it would be called. There's a little bit of filler. Right, cool. Let's have a look. Let's sell some of these stuff. Like the fascination bead. Not the chrysanite. Yeah, that can go. That can go. That can go. I know I'd probably eventually use them, but... Anything else? Nah, cool. Right. Let's see what they're selling. Nothing I can't mine very easily. An Atlas stone, I don't know what that is used for. I wonder if that's used for the Atlas Pass, though. Ooh, interesting. Iridium. I've not seen Atlas stone before. So, that's that done. Let's get back to our ship. Yeah, lots of animals. I like that. I think I've been a little bit barren. So, let's go straight forward, shall we? I don't know, maybe it was a glitch before that was making me... I think it was a glitch before making me, like, whenever I'd, like, lift off from the planet, I would just zoom into the outer atmosphere of the planet or into orbit or something like that, and it's not been doing that. It's not been doing that today, so I'm glad about that. Right, I think, yeah, this is the observatory, isn't it? Wow, yeah, land me right outside it, why don't you? Jeez. Thanks. Cool. Oh, it's right next to that beacon, that's why. You can click that beacon if you don't know. You click that beacon and it'll bring your ship to you. If you've gone on foot, like, a really, like, decent distance away, and it just takes one of those pass things that you make. is bypass chips. That's it. See how close those planets are? That those two planets there are either massive, which would affect the gravity of this planet, or they're really, really super close, like closer than the moon is to the Earth. So it's like, I appreciate the aesthetic of it, but for a game that keeps banging on about like how realistic it is, that's not realistic. And it kind of narcs me a little bit every time I see it. So I know it's a bit nitpicky, and I know like it's supposed to just look nice, but it's like, well, choose one, realism or looking nice, because usually, I mean, they're not mutually exclusive, but in this case, those two aspects are. Right, you're must be the loneliest guy in the galaxy, because this place has nothing. Let's talk to you first, then, shall we? Oh, it is going a bit slow today. It is. Pathetic multi-tool insults. Oh, dear. Friendship. Blood.
Death.
Cut my hand. Let's go for multi-tool then, because he mentions it. Oh, cool. So, what have we got? My new friend. I already know it, so I just paid 100 credits for something I already know. Well, thanks. Okay, let's have a look at the station now. I think this is going to be my last recorded video for tonight, because I am actually getting retired now. Different number, whichever one it is. It's the top one, isn't it? Yep. Go on. Let's see. So, like I said, I want to really go see the other two places first, because I always get sidetracked and I always lose, like, concentration. Again, this thing kind of annoys me a little bit as well. Like, I appreciate it. Look, it's gone up and we're having a look down on the planet. It's all very interesting. But at the same time, it's like, I really just want to get on. Just, like, just put it on my map. Point me in the direction that it is so I know how long it'll take me to get there. And I'll just go. Like, this takes a while. I don't know whether because it's procedurally generated that it is generating that ruin. Like, when you click it, it, like, plonks a new ruin on the planet. Which is what I suspect it does, which is why it takes a while, and the video sequence is just gives it time to load. Still irritating, though. These ones that shine, I'm wondering whether they shine because you haven't got them yet. So, it was just being scanned. Jeez. I could use that beacon. I'm not going to. Some chrysonite over there that I want, though. Chrysonite Futua? I think that's the other shelter. Operations center, there you go. Yeah, I'm gonna be inundated with this stuff now. It's probably like the most common material in the galaxy, and I'm just like, I haven't seen it before, I'm gonna get it all! Cool. I might make a Let's Play in the day soon. I already know that one as well. I am a fountain of knowledge. Because people are going away. My parents are going away. Yes, I live at home because I'm a student. My parents are going away, and my brother will be at work. So I will have the house to myself for a change on Tuesday. All day till seven o'clock at night when I pick my brother David up from work. So I will be able to do whatever I want in the house, and it's just going to be me and me dog. Jerry, his name is. And he's going to be miserable because mom and dad are away on holiday. So I might make a Let's Play in the day because I can just be as loud and weird as I want. I think sometimes my Let's Plays might be a little touch boring because I'm always a bit self-conscious about people listening to me, effectively talking to myself like a crazy person. I've already been in this building. Please leave me alone. You gave me nothing and you still took money off me. You con man. So, yeah, so I'm thinking about cracking out some Let's Plays. I'm looking forward to going to the next star system, I'll be honest with you. It does get a bit like, yeah, I've got loads of stuff in the star system as well. I feel like I'm almost a little bit over-prepared to go to another one. Oh, apparently I'm reversing. No, now I'm going forwards. Cool. So, yeah, this was the place that we were supposed to stop at. So we're going to go off to what we got? Ruin, plaque, and that. So let's go in that direction, shall we? We got a little bit of time left on this episode, and I want to use that time wisely. So what are we going to get to first? We got the plaque first, then the operations center, then the ruin. There was another place, wasn't there? Yeah. No, that's it. Yeah, the plaque and the operations center are the two places. Cool. So we'll visit these places, and that'll probably be the end of the episode. We'll probably run out. I don't want to drag these episodes on too long, really. There's probably only so much of this you can watch at once. Like I said, I'm getting a little bit tired. I love these big plaques, these big sort of monoliths. I know this is a plaque and not a monolith. They're actually two slightly different things. But I really do like them. I think they look cool. They've got interesting designs. I hope you can hear my voice better on this one. I've lowered the sound effects a little bit more. They're actually on like 15%. Because even at like 30%, they were still kind of overpowering my voice a little bit, especially in flight. So I understand that there's been a bit of sound issues. Hopefully these last two have cleared up. I've filmed them back to back. The Book of Herc speaks to the rise of the travelers. They shall ascend, delving into the boundless void. The Vikings shall not impede their ascent, for the travelers must prevail. So decrees the word of Herc. So I think the Herc are like their sort of deity. That's what I've sort of gleaned from this so far. I know they really don't like the beaked people, like the Gek. That's it, they really don't like the Gek. And I think it's because they don't like the Sentinels, certainly. This is what I've gathered. And the Gek, it sounds like they got rid of the Sentinels at one point and the Gek brought them back. And they're real not happy with the Gek for that. The hell is this? Oh, I've seen these weird things. They're just, ugh. Weird. I mean, there's some really weird animals. On Earth, I mean, like real animals, not just fake ones on the game that I'm playing. If you really want to look up a really weird animal, just a random thing here, look up the platypus. It's super weird. It's super, super weird. It's just, it defies all logic compared to like, you know, like mammals, marsupials and all that. It's just, it's a super interesting animal. More than you might seem. Oh, he's doing this. See, I was just like stopping me. Yeah, weird, isn't it? The platypus was so weird. Random fact here. You might know this, but you might not. The platypus was so weird that when the first explorer brought a platypus back, everyone thought it was fake. Everyone thought that they had, because obviously they had to kill the animal and stuff it back in their nose. Everyone thought that they had gotten just a different animal and stuck a duck's beak on it or something like that, and they thought they were just trying to fool everyone. Until they actually, you know, a wild one, a real life one, was live one, was brought back. So I thought that was quite interesting. Some stories for you. I'm 99.9% sure that story's true. There's always a chance that it's BS. But no, I think I was told that one night, lecture at uni. Great lecturers, by the way. I honestly, I can't complain about all but one of my lecturers. There's always one. And if anybody I know is listening to this, they know damn well who I'm talking about. So shout out to all my uni friends. We are gonna get in a fight. It's time for a battle. Once you get a grenade launcher, I've noticed that, for a start, that's not right. See how like the health of the door's not going down? Once you get a grenade, you've got to use grenades. Boom. Right. There we go. He's not going to be happy with me now. Oh, they give me a little bit of leeway, actually. No, they've been deployed. There we go. Do you mind? Look how fast my new gun is. Try not to swear too much. I've got a terrible habit of swearing. Oh, yeah, boy. One more should do it, I think. Boom! Let's get in because they'll be like called off, and then I can go find the technology that they've dropped and stuff. So let's interact with all this while it's calling them off. Right, no, okay. Right, let's find out what this wants. These are most difficult because you need to know enough of the language to understand what it wants. I find an off-world message intended for a creature posted in this station. It's oddly sentimental. Images of an infant warrior can be seen, and then a picture of the same creature as a bloodied adolescent proudly biting into the throat of a hoofed beast. In the final image, the young warrior salutes its family as it leaves a distant world. There are two locked storage vaults at my feet. The message is programmed to release only one. So we got Gra, which seems to be a general welcome, something or other, Viking War. Oh, obviously this warrior's gone off to war. Aggression, defense right, enemy blood, death, death. Now it says defense right, so I'm going to choose the vault on the right. And it worked, yes! A contented snarling sound plays. The vault contains a multi-tool technology blueprint. So what have we got? Something I already know because I am just an encyclopedia of blueprints today. Apparently, I can't seem to find anything that I need. So let's just have a quick scout on the floor for those. When you destroy those, you might know this, but when you destroy the sentinels, they drop technology. I don't know if it's disappeared or not. I don't know if it does or not, but it's not here. Plutonium. Plutonium. I'm running out of plutonium. Ah, I shouldn't be after this. Look at that beast. Cool. I'll have you as well. Oh, and a little bit of gold's on the floor. Fantastic. Fantastic. So, we'll just save it because we haven't yet. And then we'll move on. Sorry, this episode might just run over a little bit, but we'll move on to... we've done the plaque, we've done this, we'll go on and do... I think it's ruins. I think there's some ruins around here. I'll have a look at the ruins, and that'll be the last thing that we do. I hope you've enjoyed the episode. I know the last couple of episodes I've kind of talked a bit fast. I had a can of Pepsi, and I think it's just drunk. But it's late at night, so I can talk how like I want. I don't have to be too self-conscious about like what I'm saying and stuff like that. But if you prefer me to be mental, or if you prefer me to be super somber and boring, you tell me, you tell me. What I'm going to do is, I'm just going to check out this. Hey, it's a drop pod. Let's spend another over 250,000 credits. I will get to that ruin before this episode finishes. I know these episodes are a little oddly timed. Sometimes they're about 25 minutes. Sometimes they're... Anything between 25 and 35 minutes is what I aim for, to be honest with you. I think anything over that's a little like two episodes stuck together. And anything less than that is just not enough, especially for this game where there's a lot of travelling. It's a lot of running around, a lot of travelling. It takes you just like a few seconds to get to each place and... And that's more of a look at all that plutonium! I will get all that plutonium because it means I don't have to farm for it for a while. And you can actually sell it for a decent price. Cool, extra slot. 40 slots. I am just a wealth of slots right now. The king of slots. The king and queen of slots. So after this, I think... I don't think I'm going to explore some more. I might jump off. A little shout out, even though they're never going to watch this, that I listen to only one podcast, and that is called The Weekly Planet. And the idea is, if you get the gag of the name, then you should probably listen to it. It's a really good podcast about comic book movies and games and TV shows and stuff like that. It's hosted by a couple of guys who are absolutely hilarious, and I have... Oh, I've annoyed the Sentinels by taking all the plutonium. Where are you? Where art thou? I want that. Thank you. Take your X. Look at that. Look how slow that was to change. Yeah, you don't like that, do you? Have that. Have it. Right in the face. Oh, I already know it. What a shock. Anyway. No, that's not what I wanted. I wanted to reload. I'm going to blow my ship up. Right, let's get my ship. As soon as you get into shelter, they leave. So I'm going to have to do the thrusters. Look at all the plutonium I've got. It just makes things easy just to have a massive stack of it. Multi-tool. Mining beam, plutonium. I'll use a power canister for that. Cool. Let's go. Right, last thing then. Definitely last thing this time. Is that a ruin? I don't actually say that in real life, by the way. I do say ruin. I just like the sketch from Family Guy where Stewie says ruin. Alright, so we're nearly at the ruin and the end of this episode. I did just find like an abandoned area, but there was nothing in there. All the schematics I already knew. Wasn't interesting enough, so I just cut it out of the video. So, let's just end here. This planet is probably the nicest looking planet I've found so far. I know I've probably said that a couple of times so far. Oh, I found a couple of animals as well that I needed. So, I've landed a bit further out than I expected. It's fine. It's fine, we'll get there in about 10 seconds apparently. So I'm hoping that maybe I've found like most of the things that I need to for this planet already, which is quite nice, because the first planet took ages, and the third planet in the system, which you need to find stuff on, I still haven't found everything. Right. So what have we got here? Nova Glorious. Ooh, interesting. I'll have a look at that just in a second. Oh, no, apparently I'm looking at it now, because the thing does not click on what you're looking at. It's extremely annoying that way. So what are we going to learn? It's really slow today. Really slow. And I've got a feeling that's more of a server issue because my computer is a badass these days. So let's seek help. Missing. Interesting. There we go. So that's it, guys. There's something over there. I may go check that out myself, but this is the end of the episode for you. If you like this video, please press... Wow, that was good. If you like this video, please press the like button. And please do subscribe if you want to see more. I do have more... I do have more stuff that I've uploaded recently. I think my last video at the time of filming this was... Look at that! It was... A What's Wrong with the DC Extended Universe. So if you are interested in stuff like that, then please do check those out and subscribe if you want. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and enjoy yourselves. Bye. Bye.